guys, Junsik Han, he talked about phase separation quantized vortices in two components, which were both science and quantized in a two dimensional box.
So first, I'd like to thank the organizers for giving me a chance to give this talk. I talk about the phase separation of quantized vortices in two component visible Einstein quantized in two dimensional box potential. First, I explain the phase separation of quantized vortices. In this black circle in the boundary of box potential. The two component visible condensates are filled in inside of this, and red and blue points mean the positive and negative vortices. The interaction between the atoms of component 1 and component 2 is easy, then the vortices form on-server vortices. The on-server vortices is the cluster of lifetime vortices like this. In this situation, on-server vortices are formed in both components, component 1 and component 2. On the other hand, when the interaction is formed, the distribution of vortices are separate spatially. And we call this novel phenomena phase separation of vortices. So, in this talk, I have two topics. The one is formation of quantized vortices in one component piece, and the other is the extension to two component pieces. First, I introduce the previous simulation. This is a gross is all calculate the dynamics of vortices in condensate trapped by a harmonic potential like this, or trapped by T-ball potential like this. And here, blue points and green points mean the positive and negative vortices. From this, the on-server vortices are formed in the T-ball potential. And they calculate the dipole moment to judge the formation of on-server vortices. The dipole moment is defined by this equation. Si is the sign of vortex, and Ri is the position vector of vortex. And this graph shows the time development of dipole moment and the number of vortices. And red line shows the result of harmonic potential. And blue line, so that of the steep wall potential. And here, the dipole moment of steep wall potential develop enough and larger than that of the harmonic potential. So a dipole moment can be used to characterize the formation of on-server vortices. Next, I introduce the experimental study. Recently, BC can be trapped by a box potential like this. Thus, the formation of on-server vortices are studied by using a uniform condenser. In addition to this, by using the black scattering technique, the sign of vortices are detected. Can be detected. Thus, whether the on-server vortices are formed or not can be confirmed directly in experiment. Then I extend the formation of on-server vortices, the study of formation of on-server vortices to two component DC system. This equation the growth test equation for two component DC. This third term is the interaction between atoms of same component. And we call this intercomponent interaction of atoms. And this fourth term is interaction we can define component atoms, and we call this intercomponent interaction of atoms, and each box potential as attracting potential. Here R0 is the radius of box potential, and V0 is the height of potential, and we also take D11 and D22, or G equal G, and this G is positive, right? And G12 is also positive. In addition to this, we choose G12 to satisfy this miscible condition. This means under this condition, the two components are miscible in box potential. And we take the mass of atoms M1 and M2 equal and same value. In two-component DC system, there are two types of induction between vortices. One is the intercomponent induction between vortices, written by this equation. This is induction between the vortices of same component. And the other is intercomponent induction of vortices, written by this equation. This is induction between the vortices in different components. And then this G12 and this part G11, G22 minus G12 are both positive in this study. So the intercomponent interaction is always positive in this study. So next, I explain the condition of my calculation. First, we carry out two kinds of calculation. In calculation one, we take G12 equal 0.1G. We intercomponent induction from T equal 0 to T equal 1/3. Here, T is the normalized time. And in calculation two, we also take G12 equals 0.1G from T equals 0 to T equals 250. And at T equals 250, we change G12 from 0.1G to 0.7G. So in this, so from intercomponent interaction. We can do this by using Fisher-Harris. And initial distribution of voltages for both components are random. And so I show the result of calculation one. And then blue lines in show the component of dipole moment of component one and component two. And the results are similar to that of one component of EC system. And then the distribution of vortices becomes this. This distribution is the inside distribution. And with time development, the lifetime vortices clusters. And finally, Gonzaga vortices are formed in both components, like this. This is the calculation one, so the weak intercomponent interaction condition. Next, I show the result of calculation two. So then, from T equal 250, the intercomponent interaction becomes stronger. So from here, the G12 equal 0.7G. And in order to compare with the result of calculation one, and this, I focus on these three times marked by black dotted line. First, I focus on T equal 400. Until this time, the dipole moment develops slowly or almost constant, like this. So develop slowly and almost constant. And this is similar to system one of one component. And then the distribution of the distribution vortices at T equal 400 is becoming G. Then tendency of formation of cluster of right sine vortices is confirmed like this. So until T equal 400, the right sine vortices cluster. Next, I focus on T equal 700. Around T equal 700, the dipole moments of both components decrease considerably like this. And this can confirm in weak interaction component, weak intercomponent interaction state. And then the vortices concentrate the region surrounded by the dashed line like this. This. And we call this region, vortex region of VR. And also, two component condenses are mixed and filled in this inside of potential. However, the distribution of VR are separate, especially like this. And this makes the component, this makes the dipole moment of both components decrease. And like this, vortices of each component form up VR, then we call this phenomenon the phase separation of vortices of type 1. So in the type 1 state, both components have one VR. Next, I focus on T equals 780. At 780, the dipole moment for component 1 is decreased around this time. However, that of component 2 grows around this time. The distribution becomes like this. Then, the bias of component 2 are divided by the VR of component 1, like this. And thus, the dipole moment of component 2 is spread over these two VRs. So, dipole moment of component 2, only dipole moment of component 2 grows, and that of component 1 is decreased. And we call this situation. So, one component has two VRs and the other component has one VR. Then we call this situation the separation of type 2. And the both type 1 and type 2 phase separation is a novel phenomenon. And so in order to characterize gene distribution, we introduce the two types of effective distance of voltage. And one is this large R gene. So first I explain about this. Now we focus on the component one. This red point means the vortices of component one. This red does not mean the positive, it's only the vortices of component one. And this O is the origin of positive. And then we take the average of the vector of each component. So we sum this R1 plus R2 and plus R3. And finally, we divide the sum by the number of vortices. And then G these vortices exist inside of VR log n, and the average of these vectors RCD1 become like this, and this this vector point the center of gravity of body. So this point is the center of gravity of body of component one. So we call this CV1. We also calculate same calculation about component two. Then we can get RCD1 and RCD2. And then we can calculate this line up. This is defined by this equation. Then large R is the distance of between G to C degrees. And from this picture, we can say that RCD is the effective distance between the layers of each component. So this is one of effective distance of vortices. And the other is large L. So next I explain about this. In VR1, there are vortices of component one and the center of gravity for component one. And the position vector of each vortices and the CV width becomes this. And next, we calculate the distance between CV width and each vortices. The distance between CVV1 and V11 can be calculated by this by using these two vectors. And the distance of others also calculated by using these vectors. And next we take the average of these distances. And we define that average is large F. Then the large F becomes the effective size of this VR because almost all vortices is in it exists in the VR one. And this schematic these three schematic patterns show the distribution of VRs of on-circle vortices state for type 1 or type 2 state. And here, red and blue circle means the VR of each component. And red and blue diamond show the CDV of each component. And here, when the system is on-circle vortices state for type 2 state, then large R becomes very small. However, when the system takes type 1 state, large R is larger than large L. Thus, we can distinguish the type 1 state by calculating the ratio of effective distance, large P, defined by large R over large L. And if large P exceeds 1, exceed unity, then the system is the type 1 state. And large B is smaller than unity, then the system is on-circle vortices state or type 2 state. And the system can be changed from on-circle vortices state to type 1 state or type 2 state. And system also can be changed from type 1 state to type 2 state, or from type 2 state to type 1 state, easy. But this part means that. However, once system becomes a separated state, then the system cannot come back to with the onset of vortices. And this is, we confirm this by numerical study and visual inspection of the distribution of vortices. And thus, if the large P is less than unit G for a long time, then the system maintain the onset of vortices state for a long time. And if system takes the large P, if the large P exceeds unit G, then system takes type 1 phase, and thus the system takes the phase separated state. And this is the time development of large P. This graph starts from T equal 250, and before T equal, before this, so from T equal 0 to T equal 250, G12 equals 0.1 G. And at this time, we change the G12 from 0 to 0 or 0.3 G or 0.5 G or 0.6 G or 0.7 G. And the result of 0.6 G and 7 G is shown by shown in next slide. And G4 and the state of the state from G4 G13 equals 0 to G13 equals 0.5 G, the large P is less than unit G for all time. Thus a G state maintain the onset of vortices state. However, and G12 exceeds 0.68, then large P exceeds unit G, like this. and thus, when the G12 equals 0.68 or 0.70, then the system takes the phase separating state. And in order to estimate this boundary, so G12 equals 0.6, we calculate the dependence of interaction energies on G12 over G. This is intercomponent interaction of voltages, and this is intercomponent interaction of voltages. And we take the ratio of these voltages as this interaction. Then, epsilon inter over epsilon intra is proportional to this part. And this part becomes unity when G12 over G nearly equals 0.61. This means if G12 is larger than 0.63, then epsilon inter is comparable to epsilon intra. Thus, the effect of intercomponent interaction of vortices appear clearly in the shape. Thus, the vortices show the phase separation. On the other hand, G12 is less than 0.6, then epsilon intra is comparable, is dominant in the shape. Thus, the vortices form only on the vortices. The result can be drawn by this phase diagram. If G12 is larger than G, then condensates are separated. And in this study, we take G12 to sustain this mixture condensate. Although condensates are mixture, the vortices, the distribution of vortices by spatial, then G12 is larger than 0.6. And that's less than 0.6, then onset of vortices are formed in both components. And this boundary can be estimated by competition of intercomponent and intercomponent interaction of voltage. Thank you for your.